So sometimes known as a sharing economy.
In the sharing economy, people rent or share things like cars, homes, and even clothes. UW-Madison professor, we like to call her our happiness expert, Christine Whelan is back with us.
Hi there.
Christine, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
This does seem like a popular trend. You think of things like what's the driver?
Uber
and Lyft and VRBO and Airbnb and even clothes too.
And even clothes too. So in the last 10 years, we've really seen this rise of this sharing economy where instead of actually buying everything ourselves, we will rent it or share it in terms of just having access to it when we want it. So, you know, we'll call an Uber or a Lyft instead of potentially having a car. And we can do vacation rentals instead of owning a second home. But the one that I'm most interested in is this idea of sharing clothes. And recently, there have been a whole variety of new companies that have come out to send box subscriptions of clothes that you don't actually have to buy. So, of course, there are the box services and the subscription services where you buy what you are given and if you like it. But these are ones where even if you like it, you get to wear it once and send it back.
And you've actually tried this. You've done it.
For the last 3 years, I have been a devotee of Rent the Runway Unlimited. And the way Rent the Runway Unlimited works is that you have a subscription and you can have about 4 items at a time, or you can upgrade to have more spots. And I have a constant rotation of fabulous clothes. Like this jacket, for example, is a $500 designer jacket. It's an Annette Lepore jacket. And I'm going to send it back tomorrow. I'm wearing it once, I'm enjoying it, and then I don't have to own it to actually get the fun out of it.
Is there an economic downside to this?
So, you know, I wondered whether retailers would worry about this, like whether, because I in fact went shopping over the weekend, and what I did was I sort of looked just to see what I might be able to rent later on. But honestly, this is exposing a huge number of people to different brands and actually encouraging more brand awareness. So my bet is that retailers aren't suffering too much from this. The other thing that's really great about it is that there are various different retailers who are getting in the act themselves. So Ann Taylor, New York and Company, various brands are now doing this rental as a way to lure people in to get to know their brands.
They're seeing it working.
There's an environmental impact as well.
There is. It's wonderful. So rather than have all of us individually dry clean our items, I just send this item back and Rent the Runway dry cleans in bulk, which means it uses fewer chemicals. And all of their materials are reusable and recyclable. So I actually think that I get to be both fashionable and thrifty at the same time, right? So thrifty is spending in keeping with your values. And if one of your values is not accumulating things and having more stuff and being very materialistic, but actually enjoying things and then spending more of your money on relationships and experiences, this is a good way to do it.
And what are we talking in terms of expense?
So they range in, they totally range in price, but it's usually from about $60 to about $160 is where the market is looking. So at the high end of Rent the Runway Unlimited, I got a $67,000 wardrobe last year for $159 a month.
Wow, so you added it up.
They added up for you as a kind of marketing slogan to tell you, you know, wow, you're really
so
getting
it's like
benefit.
$1,600, $1,700 you're spending.
That's right, for a $67,000 wardrobe. And since I lecture and I come on and talk to you, Susan, this is so perfect for you.
I'm really intrigued by it. I'd really like to try it. And what about for men?
So, in fact, for a long time, men were kind of left out of this fun. But recently, I discovered the Mr. Collection, where you, too, can get a box of shirts and slacks. I don't know that they do suit jackets, but they do all this sort of casual to business wear clothes. And they send it to you in a box. They have a professional stylist who asks you all questions about how your lifestyle and what you're looking to do with it. And that's only around $69 a month.
And that's a rental as well.
Now, you can buy it at a discount, as with all these services. You can buy the item at a big discount if you enjoy them. But really, the fun is that constantly rotating dream closet. It's a fabulous thing. And the idea that you're having a good impact on the environment, and you're not just accumulating things. And honestly, that you get to spend your money on other things rather than super expensive clothes.
Is it a lot of work, though? It sounds like a lot of work.
Okay, so this is the downside. This is what I tell people. I really like shopping, and so this is kind of like being able to online shop all the time. And you can actually send it when you go on vacation, so you can pack less. You can have your clothes sent to you at your other location. But yeah, You're right. It's a time commitment.
It's a little bit of logistics, yeah.
It's for those who are excited about fashion, but also need it usually for work.
Yeah, it'd be fun to try, definitely.
Interesting trend. No contract you can get out of it.
No contract you can get out of it.
I
think it's a way to consume happiness. And next month, I'd love to hear if any of these work for you.
I will try it.
Mr. What?
Collection.
The Mr. Collection.
Okay, I'll check it out.
All right, good.
Christine, thanks for being with us.
Great to see you, Christine.
Good advice. Good to see you.
We'll have a final check.